Hello friends, welcome back to GK Code Labs. The topic that we are going to discuss today is not only one of the very important one in big data interviews, but also the very first question that an interviewer will ask you. That is, tell me about your current or previous project. Those who have already given some interviews will agree with me, and those who are new, believe me, if you cannot explain your project architecture, you may start your interview with a bad impression. So in this video, I'll explain you a basic overview of a real-life project architecture so as to give you all an idea what a big data project looks like. Let's take an example of an e-commerce business. Suppose this company has a million of users buying their products from different platforms. Now this business wants maximum data from these users to be analyzed to make best calculated decisions to grow their business. These users can unknowingly provide us a wide range of data, like shopping trends. We can capture what product they are buying, from what location they are buying, on what time they are buying that. Also, we can capture their payment details, what card they have used, what was the transaction amount, in which region of the world that payment was made. On a totally different scenario, user activity can also be captured. Like what was the time spent on a page, where the most clicks were done, what was the most visited page or a product. Now this data can have different nature, like it may generate every day, every hour, every week, or it could be a real time like streaming data. So let's suppose in this example, the shopping trend and the payment detail, we are receiving this daily or hourly. So we call this kind of data as batch data. And let's say the user activity like time spent on a page, clicks, most visited page or a product, this is a real time or streaming data. So whatever the batch data that we are receiving, we have to take that data from different sources and place it somewhere centrally. Usually in most of the big data projects, there is a staging area or an on-premise server where we receive all the files from business upstream. These data can be in form of flat files or compressed files. But what about the real-time or streaming data? That cannot be captured in form of files, right? Because it is streaming. It's near real-time data. Every second it is getting generated. So in those cases where a requirement of streaming data is also there, we have to use some messaging channels like Kafka or Flume. Now as we have all our data, the process that we have to start on it is ETL, extract, transform, load. You have to extract the data, transform the data as per the business requirement, and finally load it. I'll explain you these things in detail. So it sounds simple, extract, transform, and load. But remember, in big data projects, data is very huge. What if the batch data that we are receiving may reach up to the volume of 5 to 10 terabytes per day, or maybe more than that? And the streaming data may be somewhere around 2 to 5 to 10 million records per second. So how do we handle this? Now here comes our Hadoop cluster. This is the reason that we have to use Hadoop framework if we have these kind of volumes of data. So we have a Hadoop cluster with all name node and data nodes being set up. I'm not going into very deep because this is just an overview. So a project should have a Hadoop architecture based upon the data requirements, inside which for the transformation part we can use different tools like Hive, Spark streaming for the real-time data, and finally NoSQL databases are very useful in storing and easily accessing the big data. In some old projects, the Hadoop clusters were manually built with a lot of architecture activities involved, but these days companies are moving towards the cloud technologies. So many of the cloud technologies like AWS, GCP, Google Cloud Platform, Microsoft Azure, they provide us good frameworks to build a Hadoop cluster very easily based upon our requirements. So like this, we can get the data into our Hadoop cluster, perform different kind of transformations on the data, and finally save it to a required database. We mostly use NoSQL databases in big data projects. Now there is a very important concept that we have missed in our discussion till now. If you see, we have fetched all the data from users and we have set up all these big cloud clusters and all the messaging queues, staging, on-premise server, everything we have done. But was it all done as per the business requirement? We transformed our data, loaded into databases, but the data is lying there, right? So there is a very important concept that now comes into the picture after all ETL processes, that is data warehousing. Your project understanding is incomplete if you are not aware of data warehousing concept that is being used in your project. So I'll briefly explain you how data warehousing can be used in this e-commerce project. After processing all data in our Hadoop cluster, we save the required data that could be useful for business in form of staging tables. Let's say whatever we computed out of that product, location, purchase month, username, this is somehow the relevant data for e-commerce. We have to load it into staging tables. Now, after loading it into staging tables, we load it into data warehouses where OLAP cubes get refreshed depending upon the fact and meta tables. I'm just giving you a brief idea. I'll make another video on data warehousing concept. I'll briefly explain you. These cubes are divided on different dimensions like time, location, year, quarter. So all these data is in form of tables, but different operations like slicing, dicing, drill down, roll up, all those operations can be done on this data, and different reports can be generated using tools like Power BI, Tableau, ClickView. And finally, all those reports can be provided back to business as per their requirement. Suppose if they say what were the top 10 products that were sold in particular location in first quarter. So we can create a report based upon those particular cubes and generate required columns in the report which we are going to present to business. So guys, I have basically covered all the concepts that a big data project uses these days. So obviously I could not go into much details because I plan to explain it in one slide, so that entire picture of a project should be in front of your eyes when you look at this slide. You can have this picture in mind when you are answering that first question. Also, for more interview questions and use case scenarios, please watch other videos on my channel. And please guys, subscribe to my channel if you have not already subscribed. And also share this video with your friends if anyone is aspiring for big data and preparing for the interviews. So thank you guys for watching this video. Take care. Bye.